Hello, this is Jane Goodall, and I'm speaking to you on July the 14th, World Chimpanzee Day. It was 62 years ago, July the 14th, 1960, that I first stepped onto the shore of what is now Gombe National Park to start what has now become the longest uninterrupted study of wild chimpanzees. In those early days, no one knew anything about the behavior of chimps in the wild, so wasn't I lucky? Everything I saw and observed was new and exciting. The fact that chimpanzees make nests up in the trees at night, the fact that they use and make tools — at that time it was thought that only humans could do that — the fascinating development of infant chimpanzees, their relationship with their mother and their older brothers and sisters, the different personalities, the ways that different males rise to top position in different ways, and even chimpanzee females show different ways of mothering. The long childhood, chimps have a lot to learn, just like human children. Today, there's a number of other long-term studies in different parts of Africa, and we know that in different places, chimpanzees have different cultures. Behavior passed from one individual to another through observational learning. We know how adaptable they can be in different environments. And we're gradually gaining more and more information about our closest living relatives, more about their dark side — they can be violent and brutal — but more too about their gentle and loving and truly altruistic side. So many stories from so many places. 62 years ago, Gombe was part of the equatorial forest belt that stretched right across Africa, home to chimpanzees and so many groups of gorillas. Today, Gombe is an isolated island surrounded by bare hills, where more people live than the land can support, too poor to buy food from elsewhere. And today, because of the logging, sometimes by commercial companies, but also by people living in poverty. It was when I flew over Gombe and saw these bare hills and realized that people were cutting down their trees in their desperation to survive, cutting down trees to make charcoal or timber for sale, or simply to make more land so that they could grow more food to feed their families. And so one of our efforts to protect chimpanzees and their habitats is to help the local people find ways of living without destroying the environment, to help them understand that protecting the environment isn't just for wildlife, it's for their own future, the value of the forest to their future. We've started roots and shoots groups in all the villages, 104 of them in chimp habitat in Tanzania, and helping girls to stay in school, knowing that all around the world, as women's education improves, family size tends to drop. And this Dakari program is in 6 other African countries. So that's one of the ways that we're helping to protect chimpanzees in Africa. Chimps are also endangered today by the commercial bushmeat trade and by shooting mothers to capture infants for sale locally as pets or to sell to dealers who will traffic them to other countries around the world for pets or for entertainment. This is illegal, and sometimes we can persuade governments to confiscate the infant chimps who are sometimes sold in the markets or captured on their way to be exported. But then what to do with them? It was this that led to the starting of sanctuaries for these orphan chimpanzees so that they could be kept together in groups and eventually released into more naturalistic surroundings. JGI runs the biggest chimpanzee sanctuary in Africa, Chimpunga, in the Republic of Congo, and we also have another smaller sanctuary in South Africa, that's Chimp Eden. There are other chimpanzee sanctuaries in Africa, created by other groups studying chimps. And also in other parts of the world, there are sanctuaries for those chimps rescued from the entertainment business or those chimpanzees who were kept as pets. And people think, you know, they see infant chimpanzees, they see them dressed up, and they think, oh, how adorable, I want an infant chimpanzee as a pet. I want that baby to be part of my family. And they are cute when they're young. But they grow up, by the time they're 6, 7, 8, certainly by 8, they're much stronger than a human. They're not suitable pets. There are terrifying tales of pet chimps who've turned on their owners because they don't want to be pet chimps. They want to be wild and free. Something in them tells them that this is all wrong. And so creating sanctuaries where these poor individuals can be brought into social groups and gradually learn to socialize and have a more normal life. 62 years ago, chimpanzees in zoos were in terrible conditions, often one, sometimes two, in a bear cage with nothing to do. So one of the things that Jane Goodall Institute began way back in the early 70s was providing enrichment, thinking of ways so that chimpanzees, even in small cages, had something to do, and then gradually working to help zoos to get better environments more suitable to these intelligent beings. And we began the Chimpanzoo program, helping young people study chimps, because studying chimpanzees everywhere is really important. We still have so much to learn. But also helping the keepers to better understand the nature of their chimpanzees. JGI is also working to end the use of chimpanzees in entertainment. It may look cute to see chimpanzees dressed up in human clothes, riding bicycles, doing all sorts of tricks, but we must realize that training the chimpanzees to behave like this is cruel. Often they're beaten, and all of them have been snatched from their mothers and forced to live a totally unnatural life.